Hello, hello, welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X, on this absolutely awesome Thursday. Keen Software have released the beta for Automatons, or what used to be called Grid AI. Now, this covers five specific blocks, and the event controller. Now, I'm not going to be doing a massive video at the moment. This is an impromptu one because there's something hidden away in this particular update that I've wanted for ages, and I know loads of us have on the Xbox. I'm going to demonstrate it. I'm going to be going through this beta quite intensively over the next few days. I'm going to get to grips with some of the features. I've already made a follow drone. I've already made a drone that uses the recorder. I've already made a quick undock and redock flight test with one of the Red Ship Maps little ships. But to give you an idea and to show you one of the things you can now do, we're going to construct a little tiny grid out over here on this asteroid. And there's something that in Space Engineers I have been after for absolutely ages. I know my friend Sander van Oort, hopefully I've said Sander's name correctly, has been after this kind of functionality as part of the game for ages, and so have many of you. And finally, we actually have it. What is it, you may ask? Well, I'm about to demonstrate this by building a little powered grid here. And this is awesome. Now, this is an impromptu thing, so I haven't yet worked out the best way of doing it. But let's start with a couple of things. You probably know the various ways to build custom turrets in Space Engineers by now. You have two rotors, you have your azimuth, and your elevation, and the first rotor that you add is your azimuth rotor, and the second rotor that you add is your elevation rotor. So we just quickly name these. And as I said, this is an impromptu video. I decided to do it because I am so totally, utterly, and completely stoked with this update. Oops, put that in the wrong place. I'm that excited. But yeah, this completely and absolutely blows away the previous updates of Space Engineers, apart from maybe the mods. So another thing we need here briefly is red, white, yeah, green light at the bottom, the camera. Let's set our final piece of the puzzle up, shall we? And that would be our good old friend, the CTC. The custom turret controller. So let's make sure we've got it set up properly. So let's start with azimuth rotor, elevation rotor, and our assigned camera. We have no weapons on this thing. We don't need them. You'll see there is a new feature. Always aim at sun. Turning it on. Means that now our grid will track the sun. And you know what this means. That's right. No more do we have to put our grids with any timer for our solar panel arrays. Yeah. This little addition will now track the sun. Perfectly. So, no more do you need to go to my tutorial and learn how to build a solar tracker without scripts, because we now have the solar tracking script as part of the custom turret controller functionality in the game. And that alone is worth the price of admission of Automata. Except that's not the end of it. That is far from the end of it. I'll be going through this with a fine-tooth comb, unearthing lots of secrets, playing around with it, learning how things work, breaking it down, demystifying a lot of it, and redoing all of my drones to make them a lot easier. My cargo drones will be working in a completely different way, using all sorts of concepts. For a start, I could actually use a combination of the AI blocks and the event controller to make my cargo drone without needing to use the complex systems of timer blocks and so on and so forth. I can actually get the event controller to read the amount of cargo in a cargo container and trigger an action. So in other words, if my drone has dropped off all its cargo, it can launch without having to wait for a period of time and fly and scoot off to pick up more ore and bring it back. I can record a path for a drone that allows me to fly something without any issue. Like, for instance, this little miner here. Let's see. It goes. It launches, it switches the connector state, takes off, flies out a little way from the connector, and then reverses back. Now, at the moment, I've got precision off on the block and also collision detection off because I'm still playing around with various things like this. But this has changed Space Engineers fundamentally already. It's a massive alteration because when this thing lands, it switches the lock as well, because it's recording all of my actions onto this AI block. All this is now accomplished with these two blocks, the AI recorder and the AI flight move. The flight move tells it what kind of movement it's going to do, whether or not it's going to do a patrol or whether or not it's going to do anything. But I'll be breaking those blocks down individually and going through them. The recorder, on the other hand, literally allows you to take this ship, fly it all the way through this gap here, all the way round here, past this, activate its mining drills, mine a bit of stone, reverse off, fly back, decide to take a shortcut through here, skim around here, reverse, and park on this connector and drop any mined stone off. That's just the basic use of the recorder. And while I've been chatting, if you look, our little solar panel grid here has been tracking the sun perfectly. So this alone is going to make space pod starts and starts in space a lot more interesting, because as we know, we can't use wind power on planets and in space. So we need this kind of functionality for the solar panels. And now we've got it. We don't have to mess about. We can just build two rotors, a custom turret controller, some solar panels, and boom, we're done. We've got that functionality. And just to prove again that it's actually doing its thing, there you go. Perfectly tracked. And that is just two of the things. I haven't even touched on the event controller. And just because we're here, this is the event controller. Oops, spin around. Let's see. There we go. And the artwork on these blocks as well, as Zoc said in the stream, absolutely superb. Could be used as just flooring, could be used as walls, any kind of block really, and would make a great addition to a ship's bridge or a control panel. And this is upside down, so excuse me a moment. I'm going to just delete it and go back to here and just flip it. But yeah, the event controller. The event controller is absolutely superb. As I said, I'm going to go through all of the blocks individually with a separate video that dives much deeper into all of this. This is just a very quick one to demonstrate the way that Space Engineers has changed, especially down to the custom turret controller being able to now track the sun from the new option that when you've got two rotors and a camera, you can now make it always aim at sun. But the event controller can do some cool stuff. If we dive into it very, very briefly, you have a set of events and actions. And the actions are pretty much true, false. If action true, then do thing. So cargo filled, percentage. You've got altitude, angle, block added or removed, block integrity, cargo filled, cockpit occupied, connector connected, door opened, gas tank filled, landing gear locked, piston position percentage, power output percentage, and stored power percentage. And those are just a few of the things. I have a feeling that the full update may have more events as we give feedback to Keen Software. I'd be interested, for instance, in thinking on a few things. And I'm pretty much sure that with these we can do all sorts of cool stuff, like the altitude. If your ship reaches 500 meters, do this, and so on and so forth. Like, for instance, door opened. Well, if we put in a door, there's our door, there we go. And we just call it door test. And then we come back over here. And this is the first time I've touched the event controller block. So this is raw. I haven't played around with it at all. This is completely brand new. So door opened. And then we choose this block and we add this block, I believe. Do thing. Well, what is the kind of thing we could do? Well, let's see. Let's try. Turning that light on. So when the door opens, we put the light on. So let's have a look. And I said, this is the first time I've played with this, so I've had no time to actually play around with it. So we have selected block door test, door opened, select actions. So in theory, action one, interior light. True. False. Lights on. Lights off. Now, isn't that interesting? So you can do all sorts of things now. You could have it so that you can tie that door to an airlock system, making airlocks even easier to do than they were in the past. Door open, light on. Door closed, light off. Warhead behind the door, hidden there. Door open, boom. Enemy player dies. And this is just a very, very simple example of the lock. It tells you as well, if you look, the input door test is closed. And if you open it again, it will tell you that the door is opened. Now, where you can actually really spin this up is if you look at the bottom, there's an AND gate function, which means the first action is triggered if each block meets the condition, else the second action is triggered. So if we wanted that light to come on when two doors were opened or two buttons were pressed, we could do that with the AND gate. But I'll be going through that in far more detail. Like I said, this is just a very quick one to introduce some of the things from the Automata beta. And yeah, I am very impressed. And if you go to my community section on my channel and you look, you'll see instructions of how to get the beta on the Xbox. And there's two ways you can do it. One, you can search for the demo, which is actually your beta. And if you own Space Engineers, you will already have it. So if you buy Space Engineers, you will get access to the beta. And it's the first time it's been updated properly like this since, oh, I don't know, mods were a thing originally on it. So that gives you an idea of how long ago that was. You can also get it by going to the official club on the Xbox. When you get to the welcome page, tap over on the left bumper and you'll see an option to switch version. If you press the three lines, you'll be able to change version from Space Engineers to Space Engineers demo / beta. That's the two ways you can get it. And then you can play around with the blocks. As I said, it includes this thing, just to prove that wasn't a fluke. If I do this, this is the recorder block in action. If you look, it's tracking to its waypoints. See where its waypoints are, because I've got all the information enabled on the HUD. And then all I've told it to do is fly forwards to that waypoint and go back. But what's interesting about the AI recorder block is the AI recorder block, unlike the old remote control, actually records a flight path, acts on it, adjusts and brings a ship back to dock perfectly, but it also switches connectors because it can record anything that you do on your hotbar. So if I took that off, went mining with the AI recorder on, and turned the drills on, it would recognize those actions and replay them. So you could make the ship go and mine itself. But obviously you could do that using the blocks anyway, when you work out exactly how to use those with the event controller. Remember, the event controller can detect if a cargo box is full. So all you need to do is have a miner go, mine a bunch of stuff, and then fly back. Or, like they showed in the video, you can have a drone attached to a miner, detach when the cargo of the miner is full, take the ore back to base, drop it off, come back, land, lock in, and wait again until the miner cargo hold is full. All that, though, is just the tip of the iceberg. I'm pretty sure there are going to be people out there like Paul Thompson and a bunch of others who come up with even more creative ways to use these blocks that we haven't even thought of yet, because it's only been out for probably just over an hour now. Anyway, that's it. That's the event controller, a little demonstration of the sun tracking feature on the custom turret controller. And yeah, Automaton, it's looking good. And this isn't even a full example of what's coming. With the full update, there'll be even more. This is just a small scratch of the surface. I am impressed so far. Join me again for more Space Engineers content on the Xbox, exclusively for the Xbox. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for the support. Remember, as we hit the 2,000 subs milestone, we will be releasing, me and Paul, the all-terrain armored transport, two versions, and the scout walker, and possibly anything else that Paul decides to throw into the map as a goodie. You never know with Paul. He's a giving gent like me. But it is a milestone, and we're getting closer and closer to it. Again, I can't thank you enough. It's a great deal of fun to be able to do this, and I'm closing in on my 3 years of doing it now for the Xbox. Until then, though, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the update, grab the beta, play with this stuff, and give feedback to Keen. Bye for now.